Faye Webster, I know I'm funny, haha, album review, let's chat about it. Hey guys, what's going on? Johnny Everwood spinning here, and I chat about the latest from Miss Faye Webster, Atlanta, Georgia-based singer, songwriter. She started making waves around the time of her Run and Tell project. And you know what? It's an album that, at the time and still to this day, I have a lot of mixed feelings on. On one hand, there were a lot of underwhelming moments, some super bland instrumentals, but it was her vocals, as well as her lyrics that were often super lovelorn and longing, that really won me over. Now, her follow-up album, her self-titled Faye Webster album, I actually had a lot more issues with. I thought a lot of the singles were really, really good leading up to it, but there were a lot of deep cuts on here where I figured that Faye Webster just wasn't pushing herself as much as she could. But then she really put herself on the map with her last album, Atlanta Millionaires Club. I'm like, come on, how am I supposed to feel bad with this album playing? It's just such an incredibly sweet and breezy indie folk and alternative country album. And yes, it was melancholy and the sense of longing in her lyrics were even more so than before, but still it was such a escape and feel good album. And the singles leading up to this new album have been, I think, her most likable to date. Let's chat about this thing. This album starts off with Better Distractions. I think it's the best track here. I think it's one of the best tracks she's ever wrote. This dreamy, unbearably sweet instrumental is just so easy to dive into. Between the slide guitar and her warm vocal melodies, it's just, this sounds like something I would have heard on the radio growing up and just would have gravitated towards. And personally, her lyrical style, I love it. I think it's a strong opener, and this what it was, I think, one of the first tracks released from this album. I think it's one of the best. Then we have Sometimes. I love this laid back, very dreamy, very hazy style. I mean, lyrically, you know what you're getting from Faye. It's nothing really new here, but I don't think that's a bad thing because this still packs quite a punch. I mean, that line about her lover leaving her for someone who looks exactly like her, that one stung. For some lovelorn, sad girl, indie folk, and alternative country, Faye has a sound, and it's really good. She performs the hell out of this. And her quiet, very intense performances, backed up by these lavish instrumentals, is a winning formula. Then we get this album's title track, I Know I'm Funny, haha. And you know what? I'm just gonna say it. Instrumental-wise, it's not one of the more lavish tracks here. It's probably one of the safer ones. But for me, I think Faye really saves this track with her lyrical performance, which shows her packing a little bit more punch. Get a little spunky, even. And I like that. I think it ties the album together really nicely. Kind of is just as breezy, easy to drift off into. And this one just kind of makes you really want to just give Faye a hug, but in the best way. This one goes into a lot of the themes of, you know, having a budding relationship with someone, having to ask some tough questions, having hope even, and Faye really does it very well. This instrumental also super easy to take in, it's almost hypnotic. I don't even mind that this is the longest track here, it's the longest one by, like, a long shot too, it's really likable. Not only that, I will say this, it's pretty relatable. Faye takes a lot of pretty tough topics on here and makes them very universal sounding. Now, there are some misses on here. There are some tracks, especially towards the finale, that I just cannot get into. But early on the album, I know I'm in the minority here, but I am not into in a good way. This one is tough, and it's a shame because that jazzy instrumental, that is money. It reminds me of like early Natalie Press. As far as the rest of this track goes, this is a letdown. Her vocals to me aren't as warm or inviting. And lyrically, call me nuts, I don't think this is one of her best performances. I don't want to be that guy either, because as far as like a hope-filled track goes, you're not going to find a happier tune here. But for me, it just doesn't do it. And like I said, it's some of the final tracks here that just rub me the wrong way. Like Overslept? I don't know what it is, but this track and me just can't get on the same page. I feel like Faye has such a great way of bringing you into her lyrics, making you understand what she's going through or has gone through. This, to me, is like entry-level singer-songwriter. And you know what? We get a guest feature here from Mei Ihara, and her vocals are actually really nice. It brings a little jazziness to this track. But this, for me, is just, it's not my cup of tea. It's really not. And this album's closer, Half of Me, I feel like this is average too. This has been a lavish album featuring lush backdrops, emotional lyrics that everyone can understand. This is very entry level. I feel like she does this so much better on so many other tracks. Outside of that, though, while nothing radically different or out of the box in singer-songwriter, alternative country, or indie folk, Faye has a winning formula in my book right now. Cheers, not only is it the heaviest track here, it's one of the heaviest Faye's ever wrote. And you know what? It's still far from actually heavy, but we get a little bit of a crunchy riff here. We get some stiff drumming. It's also on the heavier side of topics. She dives into a relationship that's going astray on this track. But this relationship here just kind of seems like it's tearing her apart. She does make it, however, once again, very relatable. Cheers to that. Then we have Both All the Time. Emotionally speaking, this is the most real track here. Faye here goes into depression, loneliness, not wanting to break outside of her norm. It's really deep and you have to commend her for that. It's just as passionately performed and wonderfully written too, and the rest of this album kind of just, you know, made you want to reach out to her, Faye, and give her a hug. This track certainly, you know, really makes you feel that. She tackles a lot of the same topics on A Stranger too. Depression and loneliness continue. Faye goes into the fact that she doesn't feel like she knows herself anymore, that she's a stranger to herself. It's all done pretty poetically, too, with a really gorgeous instrumental. And A Dream with a Baseball Player, I've loved since the first time I heard it. It is a great single. It's very hazy and dream-like, as the title suggests. But once again, Faye brings in topics that are pretty relatable, you know, having this crush on someone you've never met, this attraction to someone you've never actually personally met, and you know that, you know, you're probably never going to meet them or have any sort of chance of a relationship with them. It's smoky, it's sexy, it's done so well. So yeah, like I said, this may not be anything outside the box in the alternative country, indie folk, singer-songwriter genres, but I think it's Faye's most lavish, beautiful, and passionately performed album to date. The singles here are fantastic, and Faye's lyrics and performances here are so intensely real at times that making things seem relatable just comes very easy to her. So like I said, while maybe not the most genre-defining or out-of-the-box album in these genres you'll hear all year, Faye makes up for that in spades with emotionally potent lyrics and just a series of fantastic performances set to very lavish and elegant and beautiful backgrounds. I'm feeling a decent 8 on this, but let me know what you guys think down below. If you like the video, be sure to give us a like, give us a subscribe, and let me know down below what you would like for me to chat about in the future. And until next time, have a great day, guys.